One of the things that I've absolutely felt passionate about is that beautiful mind of a young child, so rich with possibilities. My name's Marilyn Fleer. I'm a professor of early childhood education at Monash University. My family lived on a farm in Narrikup. That's between Albany and Mount Barker. In those days, the community aspirations for young women was pretty low, and so the expectation was that I'd grow up on the farm, stay on the farm, marry the farmer's son next door. The magic moment for me was going to the local kindergarten. One child started to count the objects, and in the process of counting the objects, I became curious when the kindergarten teacher talked about the kind of learning that was going on, the kind of thinking that the children were engaged in. I was just hooked. That was what started me on my journey to becoming an early childhood educator and later on as an academic, and I would have been 14. Early childhood has traditionally been undervalued, under-resourced. Consequently, I feel it's really important that we grow the research base. People often think that young children are these beings to be loved, but it's more than that. When we think about children as thinking people, we create an environment that's always stretching them so that that young mind's able to think in new ways. I wanted to grow the research so that we as educators in Australia have an Australian evidence-based model that is a credit model that recognises that early childhood educators are these amazing people.
Marilyn came to our school, and with my class of pre-primaries, she created a play world and demonstrated that through the story of Rosie's Walk.
Rosie the hen went for a walk.
As soon as we entered the play world, we were all in our characters. Group of bees.
You're the queen bee.
I'm the queen bee. Oh.
Group of foxes and group of chickens.
Who is stinging? We're stinging.
So the kids then went back to the tables and started making maps for Rosie's cousin to find Rosie. Marilyn's research for us as educators is wonderful because early childhood educators all know the value of play and how that is your cornerstone for children's natural learning. So for someone like Marilyn to be coming and saying, this is paramount and this is what is going to help your learning, that is just joy for us, because that push down of curriculum into early childhood is so strong, and to be able to balance that push down of curriculum with the valuable play is just perfect.
The Laureate Fellowships are the ARC's most prestigious fellowship, and they provide the funding and the opportunity for internationally recognised researchers to conduct research that is going to make a difference nationally and internationally.
When the faculty and the university asked me to put in an application, I thought, oh, that's never going to happen. And I thought, well, why not give it a go?
The competition is fierce. Everybody who applies is well recognised to be a leader in their research field.
When I got the phone call, I thought, I can't believe this. Am I hearing this right? This is a really important moment, historic moment for early childhood educators and researchers in Australia. So educators will try out the conceptual play worlds model that has come from my previous work. One of the tools we have involved in our research is an app, so educators can capture these imagination and science moments or engineering moments or technology moments, because they're so well placed to be able to do that. They will then be talking to us about what they've learned through trying out the ideas, and we in turn will be learning the best way to modify and take this evidence-based model forward. Once the children have experienced this early childhood setting, being creative and imaginative and solving lots of interesting problems, we're hoping that these amazing people will wind up being chief scientists of the future.